Hello YouTube, welcome to my channel. So, it is day one. Well, okay, it's kind of like night one, as you can see. It's dark outside, but of the vlog for New York. I'm going to Upstate, New York to visit my friends for a couple days. I was supposed to have left hours ago, but as life would have it, I did not. And so, I look like death. I did not get enough sleep. I don't think I've eaten today. I'm crazy tired. Luckily, it's not too far away. But I'm heading out now. It's around 7:10 p.m. And I'm not really going to probably have much to film today since I'm just going to be driving and going to the hotel. Originally, I was going to meet a friend and get like coffee or something to eat. But it's going to be pretty late and I think they work in the morning. So probably won't happen, but maybe it will. Who knows? I'm a crazy person. I'm just tired now. My sleep schedule is really just eternally screwed up. Like an hour here, an hour there, but all hours of the night and day, morning, whatever. So now I'm tired, not like deathly tired, but you know, I feel tired, but if I like get past this point, then it'll be like, you know, 11, 12 o'clock and I'll be like, I'm awake now. So that doesn't really work for normal people who want to do things. But anyway, I'm on my way to New York now. And the weather's beautiful. The moon, I can't show you because my phone is dumb and outside is dumb, but the moon is almost full, if not full, maybe tomorrow. But it's beautiful, and supposed to have rain on the way home when I go back Friday, but for now it's beautiful. So that is what is happening, and I will keep you guys posted, vlog-like, if anything important or interesting happens. So, thanks. So here's my little room. I don't think I've had a single before.
It has some art on the wall that is not the worst.
And there's a desk. And it has a really tall little fridge. It's not like a little one, which are like usually this size. A TV. There's the microwave. Mirror. And the really high bed. Excuse my belly. Desks. Bed is super pretty comfy. And there's a chair. And a lamp, which I should probably turn on. It's dark in here. There's the art. And, and the bathroom on that side. So, it's like 11 now. I got here a while ago. but there was lots of road work on the way down, so that added time. And then because I was just trying to get here, I kept being like, okay, I'll get the next rest stop or whatever. But I only saw two on the way. And both times, well, I didn't see two. I saw them as I was driving by them. And because both times, I was in the left lane passing people because there was traffic and stuff. And I didn't see any like notification signs. I just saw the one being like, oh, Lee Plaza or oh, this plaza. And I was like, wait, I have to pee. Oh, so the last like 2 hours of the trip, I had to pee so bad. And so then when I got to the hotel, there was a Cumberland Farms right next door. And I pulled in there and I was like, have to pee. TMI, I know, real life. But also, then I went to get like a couple sandwiches because originally I was gonna stop at Wendy's and get their awesome snack wrap things, but couldn't find a Wendy's and I'm tired. I mean, I know there's a Wendy's around here, but I don't know where it is right now and I don't feel like it. And so then I went to pay and my card was declined and I almost had a heart attack. I was like, what? I have to pay for a hotel. But I guess the Cumberland Farms was having system issues and like all the cards were down, like the system, so you can only pay in cash. So anyway, then I got here and my room is all the way around the hotel, all the way down the hall in the back. And there is an outside door and exit about two doors away from my door. And I was like, oh good, I'll just pull the car around. And then I asked the guy and he's like, no, that door's locked at night, which I understand. But that means I've had to carry my stuff. And I don't have a lot of stuff, but I've had to, like my food is still in the car and I have to go back out and get it because I had to take a break because I stupidly went out without my cane to carry the stuff because the cane just like takes up a whole hand. So, and then I couldn't get the card to open the door. So I was a little bit miffed, but I'm here now. The room is really cute. I've never been in a single. I don't think usually there's like two doubles or two queens. It's nice. Bathroom was super clean. Bed seems pretty clean. I haven't, not pretty, but I haven't looked in it yet.
fridge works, microwave seems to work, so it's good. It's just, it's just like I had to pee, and it's just really long walk, so I have to go out and get my food, and then I will probably get settled and jump in this high bed that I have to like scooch up on, and yeah, watch TV, eat some food, fall asleep. I don't have any obligations tomorrow with friends because most of them are working until like the afternoon, evening, so I'm pretty good. I might run out and see what I can do, but we'll see. Alright, that's the story, Morning Glory. Okay, I think that's it for now. It is like later now. Got all my food and I put stuff in the fridge and I put my ice water bottle in the freezer part, but it wasn't very cold in there, so I turned the number, but I don't know if I'm supposed to turn it like down to 2 and 1 or up to 7. Like there's no indicator and it doesn't make any sound, like it's not making any more of a sound, so I don't know if I turned it warmer or colder, but I'm gonna check it in a minute. But
and then let's check this out. See how my window is now white? I don't know if I said this, but there was no, the privacy curtain wouldn't come down. So there was like the kind of food curtain with like thin white stripes that like, you know, was like a shadow, but you can see outside and I can see the cars. And like there was a guy walking out there and I was like, oh, I can see that guy, which means you can probably see him here. So when I went back out to get my food, there was a guy, a different guy at the front desk, an older guy, an older gentleman. And I like asked him about it and he's like, well, they're fairly new, it should work, blah, blah, blah. And he's like, you can't see in. And I'm like, I'm pretty sure if I can see out, they can see in. And I was like, is it one way? And he's like, no. He's like, the privacy curtain should work. I was like, okay. And he's like, do you want to move rooms? If it's broken? And I was like, no. I was like, first of all, in my head, I was like, this room's fine outside of that. And I was like, and also, so much hassle to move everything. And then I was like, okay, never mind. Then I was like, they're lost if they look in. But then I tried to like fix it with a cane and I could see, I was pulling the chain and I could see it was caught on like the top of the window. I was like, oh my goodness, my life. So he came in and I called the front desk and I was like, I'm sorry. I was like, it's just really awkward. I can see people outside. And so he's like, oh, okay. He's like, well, I'm not really supposed to leave the front desk because I'm the only one here. And I was like, okay, never mind then. And he's like, no, I'll come up. So he came all the way down. Little older, old guy, shorter than I am. Little teeny guy. And he stood on this chair that I'm on now, which is like a rolling chair. You can't really see it, but it's a rolling chair. And I kind of held it because I was like, he's gonna break his neck. And he reached up there like on his tippy toes and he got it down for me. And I was like, I'm sorry. I was like, you know, I'm by myself. I don't know why I said that. But I was like, it's awkward. And he's like, no, I don't want people looking in on me. He's like, it's good. So
he fixed it for me. So kudos to that guy at Quality Inn because he gave me peace of mind. So anyway, also what I really wanted to say though was I was like looking around and I was like, oh, okay, this hotel doesn't have like drawers by the bed. And I was like, you know, like the last couple hotels we've stayed in haven't had like, you know, they don't do the Bible thing anymore in the drawers and stuff. But then I saw this one. Look at this. When I was standing up, I couldn't see it because it's all the way back in here. But there's a Bible in here. Obviously, placed by the Gideons, but who cares? It's a Bible. Bro, that is so cool. I have not seen a Bible in a hotel in a while, actually. So, kudos to Quality Inn. I'm impressed. Okay, but also, look at this woman while they're doing the Homeland Security spending. So, I guess it's live. This guy's like, blah, blah, blah. Look at this woman up here on her phone. She's like, I don't care. She's like, I hate these things. They're boring. Let me text my friend. Or she's probably playing like
Candy Crush or Raid Shadow Legends or something. This lady over here is also probably on her phone. They're like, this is boring AF.